standing for a moment for the invocation by Brother William Boslett, class of 1970 and St. Francis College trustee.
Loving God and source of all life, we are gathered here today to celebrate, to congratulate, and to give thanks. We ask you to bless each of us and the many friendships that sustain us. Dear God, please bless the graduates of the class of 2016 in a special way. We thank them for the gifts which they are and have been to St. Francis College. For each of them, for their families and friends, we pray in the words of St. Francis, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Bill. I ask that you remain standing also for the national anthem led by the cantor, Gina Ricci, and our choir director, Dr. Michael Kaminsky. You can all be seated. And to begin our ceremony, I'd like to introduce the president of the college, Mr. Brendan J. Dugan, from the class of 1968.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. I'd like to thank Tim for his introduction, and apparently he's suffering with a cold, so he's gonna be struggling through the list of names, I'm sure, later. I'd also like to thank Dr. Michael Kaminsky and Gina Ricci, our cantor, for the beautiful music they've been creating this afternoon. And yeah, we should show our appreciation. Thanks to the parishioners of St. Charles Borromeo Parish for sharing this beautiful building with us and allowing us to conduct these commencement exercises here. They've been very generous over the years, led by their pastor, Father Ed Duran, who we'll have more to say about later, but they really have been very generous in allowing us to make these graduation ceremonies a very special occasion. So I wanted to publicly express my thanks to them for that. Well, welcome to St. Francis College, all our honored guests and honorees, and but we're here to celebrate all the achievements and the class of 2016. So why don't we all start with a rousing round of applause for our graduates. All of us are so proud of all of you and all the hard work you put in to get here. And I'm sure that our pride is shared by all the loved ones and friends and acquaintances who are here to witness this. So I think it would be good for you to take a moment to applaud the grandmas and the grandpas and the moms and the dads and the brothers and sisters and the loved ones who helped you along the way spiritually, financially, emotionally, etc. So let's give a hand to the parents and the grandparents. All of you, I'm sure, developed friendships amongst yourself and built that community that was referred to earlier in the program during the baccalaureate mass, of that special community bond that's formed. I'm sure you also formed bonds with special people in the faculty and administration. So let's show your appreciation to those special people as well, many of whom are here on the stage. So now you graduates, you're going out there into the real world. Some of you to launch exciting careers, I'm sure. Some of you to graduate school. Some may be uncertain at this time as to what's next. But I want you to know that we've tried our hardest to prepare you well for what you will encounter as you take those next steps in your lives. And we're pretty confident that we've done a good job and that you will do very well. But I want to talk a little bit about what doing well means. Doing well means, obviously, fulfilling your career goals and doing things that are interesting and that you now, reaching this level of development, feel you really are anxious to go and do. But doing well from our perspective, and it's certainly our hope, also means that you will take up your role as a member of the community that's befitting of a St. Francis College graduate, someone who's engaged, someone who's a leader, someone who understands the profound meaning of things like the prayer of St. Francis. And I'm not going to stand here and read it to you, but it's all about compassion and concern about your fellow man. It's all about treating people the way you want to be treated. It's all about exhibiting the things that we've observed these people here on the stage, including the Franciscan brothers, but everybody here on this stage, the way they've treated us during our journey through our years at St. Francis College. That's a challenge, but that's something that we expect of you as you go forward. Why? It just always works out that way. If you look at our graduates and the impact that they've had on this community over the years, even though we're small in numbers, 2,800 students, 500 graduates, you wouldn't think that that size school could make such a difference. Yet year in and year out, we do make a difference. And why? Not because we're any better than anyone else in teaching them specific topics of academia, but because we live as a community with these other values front and center all the time. So that's a challenge I give to you. I want you to know, as I said before, we're very proud of you. We congratulate you, and we hope you understand that you'll always be welcome at St. Francis College in whatever capacity we can help you further in the future. So good luck to you all. When talking about the challenge to develop fully in terms of your engagement in the community, I think we have a great example amongst us today in our honoree, who I will now introduce to you. Father Ed Duran is the pastor of St. Charles Borromeo. I want to get the facts right here. He came to the parish in 2008, which coincided almost exactly with my being elected by the Board of Trustees to be the president of the college. So we've worked closely together over the period of time since then. In May of 2013, he was appointed, in addition to being pastor here, he was appointed to be the dean of the Brooklyn Third Deanery, which essentially means the coordinator of all the activities in all the parishes in downtown Brooklyn, from Dumbo to Red Hook. In 2014, he became the administrator, as if he didn't have enough to do in administering this parish, of Assumption Parish, which is in the north end of Brooklyn Heights. Father Ed was a member of the Marist Brothers for 21 years, so his life has been dedicated to education and youth. His previous postings have included St. Francis Xavier in Park Slope, and American Martyrs out in Queens, and St. I think it's Gerard Magella, right?
Magella.
Also in Queens. He spent his early career at Archbishop Molloy High School. There may be some graduates of that fine institution amongst our graduates. As director of guidance and an assistant principal later at St. Mary's High School in Manhasset, Long Island, before moving to Fort Wayne, Indiana, where he was chairman of the counseling department for 8 years at, and I think it's just fate that we're here today offering this doctorate, St. Francis University in Fort Wayne, Indiana. So he's back at St. Francis. Father Ed holds a PhD in counseling from St. John's University. a BS in education from Marist College, and a master's degree in electrical engineering from Seton Hall University. In addition to his leadership at St. Charles, he's also a member of the Diocese of Brooklyn Addiction Committee. He's an adjunct professor at St. John's, and since 2000, he's worked as a culturalization, is that right? Workshop facility at the Vincentian Center out in Jamaica, Queens. He's been a great partner of ours, a fabulous person. There's a saying that St. Francis once said, preach the gospel always, use words only when necessary. And Father Ed is certainly a living example of that kind of lifestyle and that kind of person. He also serves as the chaplain of the college's chapter of the Knights of Columbus. And for all of these reasons and many, many more good things that he's done, the Board of Trustees of the college is proud to confer upon him today at this graduation the degree of Doctor of Humane Letters Honoris Causa. Father Ed, Chairman of the Board, John Tully, will join me in conferring the degree upon Father Ed.
Thank you all so very, very much. It's been an exciting life. I will be retiring in 2 weeks. My objective is dumpster diving 101, dumpster diving 102. That's the next phase of my life. But God's blessing upon all of you. Enjoy every moment that you have. Use your talents to the best, and you will have a wonderful, wonderful life. Bless you.
So now it is my duty to introduce our commencement speaker, Dr. Gerald Galgan. It's been my pleasure to work with him for the past 16 years, but I'm afraid the idea of introducing him today is somewhat more of a duty than a pleasure. I say this because I'm sad that he will retire at the end of the academic year and that we will not be working together as much, possibly, as we have been. I'm happy for him, of course. I know his retirement from teaching will be the beginning of a productive and deeply enjoyable time. I urge you to read about him in your program and about his many, many accomplishments as a scholar and as a teacher. But this, I'm afraid, would be a poor introduction to Dr. Galgan. Fortunately for many of you, a large number of the graduates this year and many of the alumni on the stage and in the audience have taken at least one class with Jerry. For 5 decades, he has taught philosophy, classes in logic, reasoning, ethics, metaphysics, medieval philosophy, moral philosophy. He has helped thousands of students and many of his colleagues as well to question and to love ideas, to love books, to love discussion, and even the occasional argument. Dr. Galgan, as is his wont, recently gave me a reading assignment, a compendium of meditations on, among other things, modernism and on the effects of technology on the way and the ways in which we think and act. I flipped through the text. Come on, I learned something from you guys. And I landed on quotes like, "To be modern is to experience personal and social life as a maelstrom, to find one's world and oneself in perpetual disintegration and renewal, trouble and anguish, ambiguity and contradiction. To be part of a universe, in the words of Karl Marx, in which all that is solid melts into air." So I quickly closed that book, afraid of how much time I would need to set aside just to get through it, much less to think about it. But when I did, I found out just how good a teacher Jerry is. Again, as is his style, in the beginning he offers advice for how to read, not just what to read. There was a note: pick a meditation, read it slowly, let it marinate, eventually try another, and hopefully yet another. So I urge you to listen closely to Dr. Galgan. Don't worry about understanding everything that he says, that he has taken so very long and so much effort first to understand himself and then to convey to us. Let what he says marinate for a while. I believe, like me, you will want to try another, and hopefully yet another. It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Gerald Galgan, Professor of Philosophy.
Thank you, Tim. And thank you. 50 years ago, almost to the day I first set foot in St. Francis College, I was in the PhD program at Fordham, the robe, and someone told me that the philosophy department at St. Francis might be hiring. Turns out they were, and in September of 1966, I came from the rigor of the Jesuits across the water, and thought my first classes in the vigor of this Franciscan community. Now, after nearly 50 years of teaching, all but 2 of them at St. Francis, I am about to retire to commence upon a new path, just as you are commencing upon the next stage of your life's journey. I was touched and honored to have been asked to speak with you today in a ceremony marking your new beginnings. But the invitation also presented me with a quandary, for it is generally understood that commencement speakers impart wisdom upon the graduates they are addressing. And the essence of philosophy is that it examines claims to wisdom. It makes no such claims itself. Philosophy explores and questions those claims, helping students of the discipline, including yourselves, to be the disposers, judges, and rulers of their information and not its slaves. I have spent my whole adult life teaching philosophy, and as Dr. Maya Angelou said, if you teach, you must live what you teach. I have tried to do this, always keeping in mind Socrates' admonition in Plato's Apology that the unexamined life is not a properly human life, and today will be no exception. But while I cannot make any claims to wisdom, what I can do is speak with you a little about what lies ahead for you and what my hopes are for you on this day of commencement. Many of you know where you are going next, whether into the working world or graduate school. Many more of you are not quite sure what comes next, not sure which path to take in the modern maelstrom. No matter, either way, a great many of you will discover that your starting point ends up leading you in an entirely different direction than what you planned on when you commenced your journey. And this is a good thing, for just as people's wants and needs change over time, so do their talents and abilities, and so do the needs of the world. Your job is to figure out how to reconcile your desires and abilities with what the world around you really needs. Once you do, you will be able to not only do well for yourself and your family, but also do good for the world and her people. Dr. Frank Macchirola, former president and chancellor of St. Francis, used to tell students, do what you love and the money will come. He did not mean that they would get rich, but rather that they could make a living while pursuing what makes them happy. He was absolutely right, but I would add that if you do what you love, you will also be of use. Of use to yourself, to your family, to your community, as our president just reminded us. For really, the most basic and important function we have as human beings is to be of use. This may manifest itself in small ways or large, but however it does, I urge you to embrace it, to come to understand and to love what it means to be of use, even if it is only to one person. As St. Francis said, not to hurt our humble brethren is our first duty to them, but to stop there is not enough. We have a higher mission, to be of service to them wherever they require it. Follow your heart, but keep an eye on your moral compass. More often than not, we hesitate before we do what is right, not because we aren't sure it's the correct choice, but because it is not the easiest choice. Always put people before things, especially money. A course of action that makes a lot of money for a company, but harms the workers, for example, is not a moral course of action. As graduates of St. Francis College, you know that the pursuit of money is the least of what you should be thinking of as you commence your new lives. Obviously, making a living is important. We all must eat. We all should have a roof over our heads and a little money in our pockets. But there is more to life than this, And the questions you have grappled with throughout your studies here is not how to get rich, but whether and in what sense you should want to get rich. I am not saying that getting rich is a bad thing in and of itself. Rather, what I am suggesting is that if making money is your main, or worse, your only concern, you are not living the examined, properly human life. But you already know this because your studies in subjects such as art, literature, and music, the humanities, in other words, have already taught you that there is much more to life than wages. Paradoxically, what you will discover is that this knowledge, coupled with the excellent education you have received at St. Francis, will make you highly competitive in your career or in graduate school. Your grounding in the liberal arts, with their emphasis on critical thinking, analysis, writing, reasoning, and argumentation, has honed your individual talents and abilities. And your understanding that there is more to life than getting rich, coupled with these talents and abilities, means that you will prosper in whatever endeavor you commence. All of which is fine and good, but there is so much more to life. And more is what I hope for you on this day of commencement. Throughout your journey, you are going to meet many different types of people. Some will be charlatans, some earthly saints. Most of them will be good people struggling to stay good in an imperfect world. Talk to the people you meet. Listen to what they have to say. The good and true ones will shine. And I urge you to seek out those people and learn from them. I know whereof I speak, for I have been incredibly lucky throughout my life in terms of the good and true people around me. I know that you are thinking how rare it must be to find people like that, but I assure you that there are far more than you might imagine. By acknowledging some of these people now, I want to show you how many of them have embodied the plea of St. Francis to make me a channel of your peace. It is an honor to have studied at Fordham University under Dr. Robert Pollack, who in turn studied under the great American philosophers Alfred North Whitehead and John Dewey. It is an honor to have taught philosophy at St. Francis College in a department comprising Brother Pascal, Francis Slade, Gerard Farley, Joseph Carpino, Thomas O'Brien, Nino Langiuli, my chair, Sophie Berman, and my dear friend, Brother Owen Sadlier. It is an honor to have one's former students return as colleagues in the philosophy department. Doctors Ann Hartle, Alan Udoff, Mary Boland, Joseph Marino, and Peter Leonard. It is an honor for me to have engaged in dialogue and interdisciplinary work with so many of my distinguished colleagues at St. Francis College over the years. Joseph Schneider in the history of science, Frank Sorrentino in political science, Dr. James Flynn, Arthur Hughes, and Brother Jeffrey, more recently in history, Edgar and Claire Tashigan in biology, and James Corrigan in biology, Brother Leo and my former student, Aris Shohat in mathematics, Robert Fox, Gregory Tague, and Ian Maloney in English, Nick Fiorenza, Frank Green, and Jennifer Wingate in art history. Richard Burleth in communications, Robert Goldberg and Brother Art Urban in business, Clement Jedrzejewski and Emily Horowitz in sociology, John Sexton, Charles Waldrop, and Father Michael Carano in theology. And my former students, Brother Shane and my colleague Marina Gare in education. And in administration, my former students, Brother William Boslett and Brother Leonard Conway on the Board of Trustees, and Madeline Hanley, our new Chief Information Officer. There are two particular collaborations I wish to give special acknowledgement to. First, it was a tremendous honor and privilege to teach moral philosophy with Dr. Frank Macchirola. It was even more of an honor and a privilege to call him my friend. And it was through Dr. Macchirola that I met my second collaborator in academia and in life, my wife, Dr. Wendy Galvin, chair of the English department here at the college. As you can see, in our small corner of Brooklyn, I have been surrounded by colleagues, friends, students, administrators, staff members whose work, both small and large, makes the world a better place. Find people like these in your own lives. Do what you can to help them in their work, and learn what you can from them so you can use it in your own work as well. In my first year at St. Francis College, I was asked to address the Duns Scotus Honor Society, which I am been elected a member. I was asked to address the society. Over the decades since, I have discovered more and more how the thoughts and teachings of the Blessed Duns Scotus are woven through the fabric of life at St. Francis College. So it is no surprise that my most fervent wish for each one of you is that you come to understand how you manifest what Scotus calls intensive infinity. Imagine, if you will, a diamond of infinite size and with infinite facets. Each individual is a facet of that diamond, and each shines and reflects in his or her own way. No facet, no expression of intensive infinity can be imitated. None can appear the same way twice. Each of us, through the life we live, becomes a facet in this diamond. Each human individual knows the world as the author of his or her own unique work within the world, and as the finite presentation of a unique perspective on infinity. Thus, while any one person is finite, we are mortal, we all die. His or her life becomes part of the intensive infinity of divine knowledge. Deus, meus, et omnia. The motto of St. Francis College. The Socratic ideal of self-knowledge is thus realized as a unique finite perspective on Scotus's transcendental attributes of being, the one, the true, the beautiful, and the good. My hope is that you come to recognize and embrace your own intensive infinity, that you come to understand that each ordinary moment in each ordinary life is important, and that you come to realize that the one, the true, the beautiful, and the good live within you. Like Duns Scotus and Hegel, I want an infinite significance for the individual. And like St. Francis of Assisi and William James, I want an extraordinary significance for the ordinary. As we prepare to continue with the ceremony, I want to thank President Dugan, Chairman John Tully, and the Board of Trustees, Provost Houlihan, and the faculty, staff, and administration of the college for inviting me to speak. More importantly, I want to thank you, the graduates, and your families and friends for sharing a little of your time with me today. Once the graduation is over, let us take the last few steps of this part of our journey, the one we have traveled together for the past 4 years. Metaphorically, arm in arm, let us cross the threshold of this church and take the first steps of our new journeys, the ones we will commence separately as we move closer to the intensive infinity running through each of our lives. In closing, I turn to the poet, Emily Dickinson. Compound vision, light enabling light, the finite furnished with the infinite, convex and concave witness, back toward time and forward toward the God of him, that polar privacy a soul admitted to itself. Finite infinity, the chemical conviction that naught be lost. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Galgi. So the valedictorian for the January 2016 class is Chantell Manola Chimbo. Chantell, a management major with a minor in sports management and a 3.9 GPA, is a member of the prestigious Duns Scotus Honor Society, as is Dr. Galgi. And was also inducted into Sigma Beta Delta, the International Business Management Honor Society, and Omicron Delta Epsilon, the International Economics Honor Society. Actively involved at the college, Chantell was a member of the Accounting Society and the Economics Society, as well as a founding member of the Entrepreneurship Club. She studied abroad in Florence, Italy, which she says helped develop her cooking skills as well as her language skills. I didn't write that. In addition to excelling in the classroom, traveling around the world, and serving as a leader on campus, she held 3 internships in the past few years at Greenhouse Echo Cleaning for the MTA and with Madison Square Garden. Her hard work has paid off because just last week she began working full-time in the Human Resources Department at IMG, the Global Sports, Events, and Talent Management Company. All of her accomplishments are even more remarkable when you consider that she graduates a semester early, completing her degree in just 3.5 years. It is my honor to introduce our valedictorian, Chantell Manola Chimbo.
Good afternoon. Provost Houlihan, thank you for that warm introduction. Chairman Tully, members of the Board of Trustees, President Dugan, distinguished guests, members of the administration, faculty and staff, and fellow graduates. I'm honored to be here today to represent the winter class of 2016. So first off, congratulations. Today, we flip the page and mark an end to another chapter of our story. As I look out into the crowd before me, I sense a wave of emotions from everyone present. For family and friends, the sense of pride you have in your graduates' accomplishments is unmeasurable. For faculty, another class you have successfully educated and mentored throughout our time. Yet nothing can top the feelings that we graduates have right now at this moment. We made it here in one piece. We survived all those exams, lectures, and research papers that we once thought would never finish. It all started a couple years back when we opened our acceptance letters and decided to attend St. Francis College, the small college of big dreams, the college that has granted all of us amazing opportunities and opened doors for us in numerous ways. St. Francis, a liberal arts college, has given us the tools we need to go forward and succeed. St. Francis not only prepared all of us students to pass our GMATs, GREs, CPAs, or any other obstacle we will face after this day, but gave us confidence to touch the lives of others and help those when needed. The qualities we have gained throughout our years have given us an advantage after we leave this campus. We are part of a very small percentage of college graduates who have been exposed to more than just our textbooks. Molded into well-rounded and confident individuals, we are ready to start the next page of the new chapter of our story. When the provost called me to inform me that I was this year's valedictorian, I couldn't believe it. I always knew I wanted to be a good student, earn good grades, and get a job after graduation. But being valedictorian never crossed my mind. In fact, attending a private college was a far reach. You see, financially, my parents couldn't afford to send me to a private college. My parents came to the United States from Ecuador for a better future and to live the American dream everyone talks about. I've seen them work day and night to put a plate of food on the table. My parents always told me that education is key, and with it, anything is possible. I've seen them struggle and overcome fierce challenges. They taught me to face adversity and to work hard for everything that one wants. My parents didn't have the opportunity to go to college, so today we accomplished our goal. Today is a victory for my family, for my parents, because together we are graduating, accomplishing a small portion of that American dream they aspired. For all your sacrifices, all your guidance, all your love, and for never ever letting me give up, thank you and I love you. I thank St. Francis for providing me with a scholarship that allowed me to obtain an education and for not bearing my parents with the burden of school debt. My success wouldn't be possible if it weren't for other several key individuals that have influenced my life and helped me along the way. To my older sisters who have given me their unconditional support, advice, and never hesitated to listen when I needed it the most. To Dr. Anderson, for guiding me and providing me with great mentorship. And to my Greenhouse, MTA, and MSG family for believing in me and giving me the opportunity to gain an insight to the real world. We have all created memories that will last a lifetime. And although we won't miss the escalators not working when we needed them the most, we sure will miss seeing the friends we have made from all over the world throughout our time here at St. Francis. My fellow graduates, today, we celebrate our accomplishments. Always remember to be bold, passionate, and spontaneous. I leave you with a message my teacher once gave me. As you travel through life, when you stop and look behind you, may the times you've been happy far outnumber the times when fate has been unkind, and may much more happiness await you on your journey yet to be. Never give up on your dreams. They are yours, and no one determines what you can and cannot do. Work hard and don't ever underestimate your power. And don't ever take for granted the opportunities you have been given. Class of 2016, today we start the page to a new chapter. The future is ours. Let's do extraordinary things and show the world what it means to be a Terrier. Thank you and congratulations.
Okay, so you ready to graduate? I ask President Dugan and Chairman Tully to proceed to the center of the church to present the graduates with their degrees. So first we have the candidates for Bachelor of Arts, Adrian Maria Avedisian. Marta Bilan. and a graduate both of the college program and of the college's program in Segovia, Heather Lynn Bordner. Diana Canone, summa cum laude. Gregory J. Cronin. His diploma is presented by his father, Edward Cronin, from the class of 1978. Calvin Y. Dubuisson. Brittany I. Heafy. Thomas Robert Hickey. Annalisa S. Janga, magna cum laude.
Thank you.
Julia B. Jenkins. Courtney S. Johnson. Juliana Mayumi Yoshikawa Kagami, cum laude. Brian F. Leary. Jesse L. Lectura. His diploma is presented by his brother Chad from the class of 2007. Patrick J. McCormick, magna cum laude. His diploma is presented by his aunt, Sister Joan Gallagher. Isabella M. Moraes. Anita A. Zankala. Audrey D. Sanders.
Audrey?
Oldine Saint-Hilaire. Sydney Alexandria Rodriguez. Javier A. Rodriguez. Fiona Grace Sullivan Rivera. Alexis Marie Rivera. Jacqueline Raja, summa cum laude, and recipient of the Philip Andrew Carano Class of 70 Scholarship. Her diploma is presented by Father Michael Carano from the Class of 1966. Thank you. My esteemed student assistant, Mikhail Petrosian, summa cum laude. Devin O'Donnell. Miranda Paljevic, cum laude. Dwayne D. Waters. And the candidates for Bachelor of Science, Michael Aboulaye. Omid Adabi, cum laude. Nicolette N. Augusto. Andy Roberto Almanzar. Elijah Antoine. Darnell Auguste. Joanna Balundo. Joseph Michael Caron. Michael Cerrone. Ellen Savalos, cum laude. Chantell Manola Chimbo, summa cum laude, valedictorian. Liseth Choez. Ileana Concepcion. Inelsi Estefani Diaz. Joshua David Feliciano. Alessandria C. Ferrigno. Jose Rodolfo Galvez. Daniel Granito. Brittany Gresser. Christopher Alejandro Guevara, magna cum laude. Misato Hajikuchi, summa cum laude. Jonathan S. Herbert. William Dylan Holmes. Jing Mei Huang. Carol Omar Israel. Melissa A. John. Amal Kamis. Sashana Felicia King. Bridget Mary Last. Gustavo Leal. Jonathan Micaiah. Brendan P. McHugh. Mabel D. Mejia. Steve H. Middleton. Emmy A. Moranta. Gabriel Marone, cum laude. Sade Marshall Newport. John Patrick Newman. Beo Bankole Ogunyemi. Gabriella A. Ortiz, summa cum laude. Ismet Paljevic. Diani Dorje Parha. Jimmy D. Paul. Peter A. Pinto. Jaili Ann Quinones. Christine Marie Rabovich. Christopher J. Risley. Amanda J. Rivas, cum laude. James Andrew Rodriguez. His diploma is presented by his uncle, Monsignor Alfred LaPinta. Valerie Elizabeth Rodriguez, recipient of the Brother Robert Smith Scholarship. Brettley Sade Ruiz. Murina Sahadeo. Emria Sainovsky. Michael V. Scalera. Farah Shaney Sharee, cum laude. Travis R. Smith. Yulisa Devi Sohan. Andrew T. Wint. Laura Kiendi Yancey. Wow. And our first Master of Science student, Irina Kravchenko. And if I could ask the faculty from the Department of Management and Information Science to stand. This is the first ever graduate certificate in project management. I congratulate the department. Alan Bajwardin. So if I could ask the class to stand, please. As a symbol that you have passed through a stage in life and are now ready to face a new one, I ask the graduates to move their tassels from the right to the left. It is my honor to present the St. Francis College class of January 2016. Work. It's my pleasure to introduce Sarah M. Bratton Hughes, class of 07, the president of the St. Francis College Alumni Board of Directors.
You guys thought you were done. Good afternoon, President Dugan, Chairman Tully, members of the Board of Trustees, faculty, family, friends, and most importantly, you, the newest alumni of St. Francis College, the class of 2016. Congratulations. You now have something no one can ever take away from you, your education, a college degree. It seems like just yesterday I was sitting amongst you, excited, proud, a little bit nervous, but ready to take on the world. I'm going to share a very few amount of things I've learned in my days since SFC. First, you need to decide that you want it more than it will challenge you. You're going to have good days and bad days, good bosses and bad bosses, good relationships, bad relationships, days that you win the Powerball, and days like today. It is how you deal with this that truly reflects your character. You either fall down or you get up. We're terriers, we get up. And not only do we rise, we help those around us rise too. Embrace the inspirations that surrounded you daily during your time at SFC. The ones who taught you and continue to teach you to keep your head up, working hard no matter what. Secondly, never forget where you came from. St. Francis will always be home. SFC is a community that's here for the rest of your lives. You will forever be a terrier. Come back, and yes, please give back. I'm not just talking about monetary commitments. I'm talking about coming to alumni events, supporting the school, and giving as little or as much as you can. I give back because, like many of you sitting in front of me, I was a scholarship recipient. It was important to me that I give people just like you the same opportunity to education that I had. Also, I want you to know this alumni network you have at the school is amazing. If you are active in the community, it will come back to help you. There's not enough time for me to tell you the countless stories, including my own, of people who have received mentoring and jobs from fellow alumni. Success will come and go, but integrity is forever. Stay true to you, your values, and your beliefs. And most importantly, yourself. This is a great article I read, and I want to share it with you as you're embarking on the next stage of your life. Success will come and go, but integrity is forever. Integrity means doing the right things at all times and in all circumstances, whether or not anyone is watching. It takes having the courage to do the right thing, no matter what the consequences will be. Building a reputation takes years, but it only takes a second to lose. Never allow yourself to do anything that would damage your integrity. And my final bit, stop trying to find yourself and go out and create yourself. You could spend years wandering aimlessly trying to find yourself. Or you can walk out those doors right now, chase your dreams, and create the life you want. You are ready, you are prepared. Go out there and make us proud. Once again, congratulations to the newest Terrier alumni, the class of 2016.
Thank you, Sarah. So I think now we're at the benediction. Unless anyone else wants to talk. It's my pleasure to introduce Brother Owen Sadlier, class of 69, the College's Department of Philosophy and Religious Studies.
As we bring to a close this winter 2016 graduation ceremony, let us recall that we are now and always in the holy presence of God. Dearest Lord, on this graduation day, our hearts are filled with joy and gratitude for the wonderful years together at St. Francis College. For the love and support of our families, we thank you, Lord. For the countless lessons we learn through long hours of study, we thank you, Lord. For the gift of true and lasting friendships, we thank you especially, Lord. At the same time, Lord, we offer you these thanks for all the good things of our yesterdays here at St. Francis College. We seek your continued blessings on the great challenges of all of our tomorrows. We ask you to guide us and direct our talents, imaginations, and insights into careers of noble achievement. We ask you to bless and inspire our love of truth, of goodness, and beauty into lives of sincere devotion to others. Lastly, dear Lord, we pray that blessings of love, joy, and peace may fill our hearts, our homes, and our city, and our world, now and forever. Amen. Congratulations.
Please join me in singing the alma mater.
Affection for